Hey guys, Perochialjoe here, bringing you a let's play of Stalker Call of Pripyat. This is the sequel to Shadow of Chernobyl, and at this point, GSU Game World knew that they had kind of betrayed their fan base with Clear Sky. Even on, if you bought this game on Steam when it was released, you had a thing called the Stalker Loyalty Discount, where if you owned Clear Sky or Shadow of Chernobyl, you actually got a discount when buying this game. And it's good that they did that, because it did bring back some of the fan base that lost interest in Stalker after Clear Sky. And this game is a huge improvement over Clear Sky. It's really what it should have been from the start. So let's not waste any more time, and we will get right into the game.
At 0123, on April 26, 1986, the reactor of Power Block 4 of Chernobyl NPP is destroyed following a series of thermal explosions. The resulting radioactive cloud moves across the European part of the USSR, Eastern Europe, and Scandinavia, eventually reaching America. The consequences of the disaster are so serious that the government is forced to begin evacuating the residents of nearby towns and villages. A 30-kilometer exclusion zone is created to stop residents from returning to the contaminated area. Despite the disaster, the Chernobyl NPP continues to operate. The existence of a power station, as well as the fact that the area is no longer inhabited, leads the Council of Ministers of the USSR to set up a network of secret laboratories in the exclusion zone. June 11th.
You want to run that by me again, game?
June 11th.
That's what I thought you said. Oh, well, I guess it could be worse. I mean, it's not like it's a year off or anything.
2006. The exclusion zone lights up with a flash of blinding light as clouds can be seen evaporating in the sky. After a moment of complete silence, a peal of thunder shakes the ground. Most of the government forces guarding the perimeter are killed instantly. 2008.
Guess I spoke too soon.
Scientists are still unable to explain what happened. Rare expeditions into the zone usually end in tragedy, with survivors telling stories of mutated animals with incredible abilities roaming the area. According to various estimates, by 2010, the zone is home to between 1 and 300 unknown individuals. They call themselves stalkers and make their living by collecting anomalous formations known as artifacts, which they sell for considerable sums of money. 2011.
I swear this game is an improvement over Clear Sky.
Despite military cordons, the stalker phenomenon is growing in numbers. However, stalkers travel primarily around the zone's edges, with the center remaining terra incognita. The few attempts to penetrate deeper into the zone have all ended in failure. 2012. A stalker called Stralock solves the secret of the Brain Scorcher, a man-made emitter that had blocked the way to the center of the zone for years. After the Brain Scorcher is disabled, all stalkers rush for the center of the zone, some in hopes of finding a treasure trove of artifacts, others in search of the Wish Granter. The government decides to launch a large-scale military operation. Operation Fairway, as it came to be known, involves using maps of anomaly fields to maneuver helicopters to the CNPP. Despite meticulous preparation, the operation is a failure, and none of the helicopters return from the mission. Major Dektarev, a USS special agent, is sent into the zone to investigate the disappearance of the helicopters. Disguised as a stalker, equipped with a regular assault rifle, 2 weeks' worth of supplies, and a radio to communicate with HQ, the Major begins his journey towards the center of the zone.
Well, that was kind of abrupt. No, I didn't press any buttons either. That's just how it naturally is for some reason. They just throw you right in the middle of everything. Let's take a look at our inventory here. We've got the AKM, we've got Makarov pistol. And we've got our 2 weeks' worth of supplies. A slab of bologna, a can of God knows what, and some bread. 2 weeks' worth of supplies, huh? I think I'll eat it now. Those good rations. Now, if we look on our radar, we can see a golden star to indicate a stalker group leader. Hey, you guys got any food? I kind of ate all mine. No, but he does have information about the safe zone in this area. This is where we can meet up with other stalkers. We can trade, get food. We can upgrade weapons and all that. And you might notice those yellow circles. Those indicate helicopters. So we have to go to each of those circles to find the downed helicopters. Might as well get a jump on that before we go into the main base, because not really too much of a reason to go there right now. I mean, we did just eat 2 weeks' worth of supplies, so I think we'll probably be good for a while. And you might be thinking, I don't recognize this area from Shadow of Chernobyl. And you'd be right. They actually did go ahead and made new areas. This place looks a little dangerous. I think I will go around. It's an important area, so we'll be coming back to see it later. Don't worry. Is that our first challenger, I hear? Oh, hello, Barkeep. Welcoming us into the world of Call of Pripyat. See you, Barkeep. Important things to do. As you may have noticed, the knife did get quite a bit of a buff. You can slash extremely quickly now. Whereas before, it was just slightly faster to slash than it was to stab. Now it is much, much faster to slash, and the slash is very powerful. A lot of enemies do not actually have protection against the knife. Okay, that is one creepy-looking lion. Especially how he's just gazing over the bushes. Makes me think, hey kids. Yeah, let's get out of the petal lion's lair. Oh,
get
bandits.
Thing out of my face.
And they aren't attacking. They aren't even hostile. Wow. And they're helpful? Huh. That's actually pretty nice. Thank you, bandits. I will not kill you now. Yet. Don't worry, our great betrayal against the bandits will come at some point. Another one of the items that was included was the Echo Detector. Basically, it detects artifacts. And that looks like a helicopter. I wonder if they left any of their rations behind. I'm getting kind of hungry. It is kind of surrounded by some anomalies, and you might notice the hazmat icon in the upper left-hand corner by the radar. It's gone now, but it was there. And that's because there is a new damage type, the chemical damage type, which can be brought on by poison gas. Fortunately, they added helmets in the game, and our helmet right now is a gas mask, so we have decent protection against it, and other kinds of damage types brought on by anomalies. You can hear that beeping other than the anomaly warner. Every now and then you can hear a beep on the echo detector and see the little light blinking, and that means that there is an artifact nearby. No food, but we got a silenced pistol, some pills, and a med kit. That's a decent haul, I'd say.
All the electronics inside burned out. Even the power cable sheaths melted.
And That's really about it for this helicopter. I want to go find that artifact. We didn't do a whole lot of this in Clear Sky because it wasn't necessary, but in this game it really is. So basically once you get close enough to where the artifact is, it will wind up popping up and you can grab it. This one gives us more chemical protection, but also gives us constant radiation, which I'm not a huge fan of growing a third arm, though it might be useful in the zone. But for now, I'll stick with two, so we're not going to equip it. I'm just going to keep it in our lead-lined bag, so we don't get any of the radiation damage. Might as well show off the Makarov here, because we're going to be replacing it very soon. It's not all that accurate, not that powerful. So I'm going to unload the ammo and send it back to our backpack and pull out the silence pistol we just got. The silence pistol is more accurate, got slightly less damage, a little more handling, but it's silenced, so it's basically a silenced, slightly more accurate version of the Makarov. And usually if you can see a field that's got little anomalies in it, then generally you'll be able to find artifacts there. It'll be much easier as we go on and get better detectors. Thanks to the increased slash speed, we can actually take out large packs of enemies with just our knife, and it's actually the best strategy in most cases. You save a lot of ammunition, and it actually saves quite a bit of headache too, because most enemies will try to evade you after they attack, and you can chase them down and slash them in the back easily enough. So we found a second helicopter, though it's next to a poltergeist throwing stuff at us, so let's hurry up and get to the helicopter before it decides to throw it at us.
Looks like the crew died in midair and the helicopter simply crashed because there was nobody there to fly it. The onboard computer was a little luckier. I wonder if there's anything useful here. Ah, there's something. A map of the area with certain locations marked. That should come in handy.
Now, despite only throwing tiny little wooden boxes at us, those things hurt, so we want to get out really quickly. I'm just going to loot these bodies to get some of this stuff. Got an AK-47 already. Or I guess it's still an AK-74, but whatever. Want to make sure to loot all these grenades off of their bodies, because grenades are extremely useful in this game. No, they still suck, but they've got an alternate use. Goodbye, AK-74U, I hardly knew you. So now we've got an upgraded assault rifle. I'm taking the slightly more damaged one for a reason, but we will get into that later. That really only leaves one last helicopter that we can get to right now, so might as well head on over and see if we can find anything else out. And of course, Major Diglabba is a little tired, so we do not have any stalker juice, unfortunately. So we have to find some of that later. And what's this? Yeah, people don't like us running around exploring. What jerks. So if we bring them some food, then they will decide to let us in and join their social club. Fortunately, we do not have any food to spare, because, well, we lost it. Anyway. It says that you need to bring them 6 sausage, 6 bread, and 6 of those cans, but you really don't. You just need to bring 6 of one, and dangerous ring of fire. That says treasure to me. Let's head on in. And get our faces burnt off. Any treasure in here? No, just fire. The detector's going nuts, so... There it is. That's really all we needed from there. We've got three artifacts already, off to a very good start. And that is a... dead thing. Man, I was hoping it would kill him so I could get his gun. No such luck, though. Ah, well. We'll get more advanced stuff very soon. We're close to the helicopter. And we can actually see it, though it's a little high up, and we can't actually climb up this wall, so... Well, we just got a new objective. We have to talk to some stalkers to figure out how to get onto there. And I think I know where to go. Yep, the safe zone that we were told about to start. We will go there next time. Thanks a lot for watching, everybody. I will see you then.